Hello, everybody. My name is Richard Mabian, and I am an environmental literacy instructor for an organization called Building a Sustainable Earth Community. We're located in Kansas City, Kansas. When Ms. Gardner contacted me about being a presenter at this online public event, Discovery Day, Brilliant Botany, she said she felt the audience would enjoy learning more about what Building a Sustainable Earth Community is doing as far as its initiatives that we use to educate the community about gardening, food, and other environmental issues too. So the first slide that you see is showing the name of the company, along with some information on me, just in case you wanted to be able to get in touch with me. The first slide that I'm showing has to do with a situation I found myself in when the manager for the Hilton Garden Inn in Kansas City, Kansas, came to me. Everyone knows me as kind of like the unofficial Green Czar. I'm the president of the Kansas City, Kansas NAACP. I'm also the first black board member for the Kansas Sierra Club. I love being able to say that, by the way. So he wanted to know if I thought it was possible that I could find a group of students who would help him put a garden in at the Hilton Garden Inn. And I said, well, it makes sense for us to do that. So I started looking around to see what I could find. I got in touch with associates of mine I work with, the Kansas City Community Garden folks, because anytime you're talking about building some type of garden, I wouldn't even begin to deal with it if they wasn't directly involved with me. And then I went up to a local inner city middle school, Northwest Middle School, which was already engaged in gardening with raised beds at the school, but this would give them a chance to get engaged in doing that kind of work with a business in town away from the school. This slide is dealing with the day that we were going to start the process. And this is one of the fellows from Community Garden comes out, came out early, got the ground fixed for we're going to build the raised beds. And then he had the wood laid out because when the students got there, they could immediately get involved in building the raised beds and filling them up with dirt. And that's what happened. In this particular picture, the next slide, the school arrived, the students arrived. They got a chance to meet the people there from the community garden, got a chance to meet the people from the hotel. And the photo at the bottom is really a classic to see those young people out there working in concert with each other, with the teachers in the class, with the people from the community that was there, taking care and eagerly building those raised beds, getting ready to plant seeds in them. This is another classic photo. This is a minister from in town with the suit on and his tie that was out there working till he got so hot he had to come out of that coat, but he still stayed out there working with the young people. And that picture up at the upper right, the guy with the black coat on, is another minister. It's really good for them to have a chance to come out and work with our young people directly out of school. I think it gave them a sense of ownership for what we were out there trying to create. And the picture at the bottom right is the manager getting a shovel in his hand and he too getting involved in helping to prepare those raised beds. It really went over well with the students to know that they were performing for not just for the school, but for people in society. And they really took heart in everything that they was doing. After they got it good and watered, this is what we ended up with having at the end of the day. You have the hotel on the left. On the right was the Reardon Convention Center. And the big tall building back there in the back, it was the U.S. Courthouse that's in Wyandotte County. So it was a historical location for us to be having the youngsters there to build this. Okay. When the youngsters came back, you can see them as they're arriving in the van, and then as they're walking up on the garden and getting a chance to see the food actually growing. You know, to have a program like this, you have to really takes a lot of coordinating. Thankfully, the superintendent of school at that time was Cindy Lane, and she made it possible for us to have that van for transportation, so the youngsters had a way of getting there and getting back to the school. The teachers, the science department teachers, were able to leave the school and have the time to come over and do this. So even he is impressed with what he sees growing. You can see it in the space. On this one, we have the cook, the chef outside. And they're really excited because the radishes were ready to be picked. So you see everyone grabbing them a radish one way or another. The picture at the upper right is one of the classroom instructors and the manager of the hotel and a receptionist at the front desk. And at the bottom left are the two instructors with the students, the two teachers from the from Northwest. And what the cook, the chef is doing, he told the students that he can take a radish and he'll carve it into the shape of a mouse. And he uses those kinds of carvings on his cheese trays. So, and I love the way the youngsters would be just captivated by the things that were going on around them as he's carving that radish into the look of a mouse. They danced some more things to plant. They did some watering. And then, as usual, they hit back on that van going back to the school. One thing about this that I really thought was good for this project is the manager at the hotel gave it his commitment. He was committed to it. And as you can see, he's walking the youngsters to the van. This was their last and final time coming to the garden. And as you can see, the garden was ready. The broccoli is grown, the lettuce is grown, the vegetables are ready to be picked. And I mean, this was the day we had been waiting on. And so immediately the teacher who's up there in the blue Roche jersey starts cutting the heads of the broccoli off and down at the bottom, the chef and the assistant manager are out there picking things that are ready to be picked because the chef had told the youngsters when there was some food ready to be harvested, he would come in with them, harvest the food, and bring it inside downstairs to the hotel kitchen, and he would prepare them a meal from what they had grown. And again, he's excellent as far as carving things are concerned, and you can see the youngsters just totally entranced, just in what he's doing, you know. And then once he finished, he handed them a plate where he had carved up some lemons and some more radishes and some tomatoes to show how he would garnish different trays with food. And then he started putting together the salad for him, brought over his fellow cooks that worked with him, and they started preparing the meal. I think they ended up with some noodles, Alfredo noodles, to go along with the vegetables that they had cooked. So it was something that was very tasty, believe me. Everyone enjoyed it, believe me. Even yours truly made sure I had me a plate of it. It was really good. Then this was, the final day for the students to be coming. When you have a garden in the springtime, the earliest you can possibly get in there with your students is in mid-March, late March, depending on the weather. And so then you got all of April and then May school's out. So you just have a brief period for them to be involved. And it was really great that we were able to accomplish what we did in that length of time. And it's my bottom picture with them, Ray, that they were leaving. They all had a bag of vegetables that they were taking home, and the mama or whoever it is they're living with. And that picture at the bottom with them waving, it was, again, a priceless shot to be able to see the enjoyment they had received from what we were able to accomplish. Okay, now we got the garden planter. What are we going to do with it? We use it as a teaching tool. The top photo is a grandfather, one of his grandbabies, to come out and actually have an experience seeing what it was to plant a garden. So that particular year, that's what he did in that particular box, and it was his family's box. And that gave the kids a chance to see how you plant it, see how you maintain it, and see how it grows. Oh, the right-hand side, that's a professor from Donnelly College bringing out some of his college students, because really some of them may decide they want to get into the environmental services. They could be out there doing in the community what I'm doing in the community, and that's what this is all about, giving them a hands-on experience of what it is to do something like this. The other two guys there, the one in the blue pants and the one with the white shirt on, those are two fellas in the neighborhood who had a desire to start their own community garden in a neighborhood. And so they came over to spend some time with us to see what it was you do to create this kind of circumstance. They also got a chance to meet the people from Community Garden. So that when it came, and then the picture on the left, I want to get that before I go to the next slide, is a high-rise, a public housing high-rise for the elderly. We were able to, with Community Gardens, to put in 8 raised bed gardens over there, and with help from volunteers from the NAACP, volunteers from our environmental organizations, to come in and actually lay them out a garden. So now they have a place that they can, right there on their own ground, grow some food, and they love it. This was the next shot of when the guys that wanted to create the community garden got started, and so the community, Kansas City Community Garden people, got out there with them to help them see what it was they needed to do to get started with their garden. And here they are dealing with a tiller and a raised bed to show them exactly how you go about doing that. And I captured these two photos for this PowerPoint of when they had really expanded to a point of creating an organization, creating relationships in the neighborhood. And this was the kind of garden they had to present for that neighborhood. Dorothy Barnett, the executive director of Climate Energy Project, got a chance to meet the fellows, and she found an organization that was willing to donate money to put up a fence. And this was the day that she and some of the other members of her organization had a chance to come up and actually get a chance to see what that fence looked like. And so again, that was a offshoot of starting this garden to begin with. One other activity that I wanted to show was a guy in town named Joe Jennings has a 8-acre organic farm called J14. Now, he's up in his 90s, so he's not as active with it as he used to be, but he gave us an acre. He loaned us an acre to use for a summer. And the guy there with the black and white hat on is the guy that was the minister that had the suit and the tie on. He came out and he started working with young men, showing them the necessary steps you had to have to begin to produce a garden. And that's what this photo was about, which became another activity we got from planting the garden. And I threw this in there because the guy with the organic garden came to me with a bag of seeds and said, Richie, I'll tell you what, why don't you see if you can grow some cotton up there at the Hilton Garden Inn. He had grown some on his farm. In fact, I think it's in the museum in Wyandotte County there. He had a bale of cotton that he had grown on his property and somehow got it baled up and the whole bit. So we planted the seed, something I had never done, and most people that I'm around had never even seen cotton grow. And lo and behold, it started growing, and it became a beautiful plant. People came from all over the metropolitan region. They brought their kids multiculturally. They wanted their kids to see cotton growing, to see what it was about, to pick a pea, something that you just don't get a chance to do in this part of the country. This photo I'm taking here is with State Senator David Haley. He came down so he could experience what it was cotton was all about, and he actually picked him some and said that he was going to put it in his office at the state capitol. My final shot is this one. We started this project in 2015. And this is just a few shots of different times of what we were growing there and how it looked and what we were producing. So if anyone was interested in it, we could use this particular slide to show people what you can actually do with your own hands, a little work and a lot of effort. Again, there's my name and address, the name of the company, contact information. If you would want to get in touch with me, you can. I want to thank you for considering us to be a part of this presentation. It has been a thrill. I'm sitting here talking in my own camera, making this film ahead of time, and it adds a new part to my resume. Thank you all. God bless you.